It is dubbed the silent killer because everyone wants to hide the condition. The feeling of shame at having it is unbearable. Agnes Wayua knows this only too well. Her 10 children were infected with jiggers. One of her children and a grandchild died because of it.
For that long time of jiggers and poverty, nobody recognized me in the village. Nobody could visit me or even greet me until they saw some signs of help. They began coming in one by one to join me because of what they were seeing. But some others, even up to today, gossip about me.
Help came from Ahadi Trust Kenya, an aid group aiming to wipe out jiggers in East Africa, provide support for those who have the condition, and reduce its stigma. Stanley Kamau is Ahadi Trust Kenya's founder and executive director. Kamau says he and his group were targets of intense abuse from politicians and community members when they started.
I could not visit my village where I was born. I could not go to the schools where I went to school. The schools I had for many years contributed in building, they could not welcome me.
The parasites are usually found under the skin of the feet and hands. Children, who account for more than half the cases, are especially impacted. If their feet are badly infected, they cannot walk to school. Ahadi Trust Kenya was eventually able to open medical camps, where the affected come to get treatment and counseling. Social worker Maureen Wangari Karanja is part of an army of volunteers who do what most people would refuse to do.
I'm doing this out of love. When I was growing up, there were many people around me with jiggers. I used to watch my mother remove jiggers from these people. Now I am a mother. I spoke to the health workers who gave me medicine to treat the ones who were infected.
Karanja and her colleagues treat jigger-infested body parts with soap, water, potassium permanganate, and lotion. There is no drug to cure jiggers, but a German researcher is developing a drug after working with Ahadi Trust Kenya. The tide is turning. Where once Ahadi Trust Kenya and their clients were shunned, they are now becoming celebrities of sorts. Miss World 2011, Miss Europe, Miss World Kenya, and the grandson of former South African President Nelson Mandela all washed jigger-infected feet at the group's most recent medical clinic, thrilling the crowds with their presence. Kathy Maitney for VOA News, Kiambu.